Hello students, this is the final video in your course on content marketing. Herein we will talk about the conclusion of this whole online course on content marketing and of course discuss a course summary. So over a period of time, you have come to develop certain key takeaways. You have, of course, gathered some key information, some key inputs and insights from the course. So herein we'll discuss one by one that how through each chapter we discussed various important elements of content marketing as a career, as a profession, as a function for an organization, and what as a professional you should be taking away from this course and how you can apply it in your future career endeavors. So in the beginning we learned what exactly is content marketing and why companies need it, how it is becoming the trending thing, especially when more and more customers are becoming search savvy, are becoming social savvy, and they are trying to learn more about the brands that they do business with. And in order to do that, they are looking for value adding content before choosing the brands that they want to buy or that they want to collaborate with. So in the very beginning, we set the premise clear that content marketing, why it is emerging as a trending career opportunity and as a viable career choice for youth today, because obviously there is demand for it, and the demand is arising from the company side because the customers want quality content. So we discussed that. Then we moved on to discussing how to develop content marketing strategy, which is the first step in the professional career of any content marketing manager. Because even if a content marketing strategy exists for an organization, you would obviously need to first understand it, identify gaps in it, and rethink it so that you can drive results which are expected of you. So we talked about goal setting, we talked about identifying target customers, we talked about aligning goals with KPIs, and we talked about critical steps in designing content marketing strategy using tools like content calendar, editorial calendar, content management system. Then we talked about why it is important to begin by developing the best website content and how website serves as a foundation in any content marketing strategy, any content marketing campaign for any company. So we discussed different elements of a website, different types of pages which are a must to be created, what kind of information should go on each page, how the website design and layout should be like, and how much of an intervention can a content marketer make there is also something that we learned in this course. Then we went on to discuss different content formats which can be used for offering additional value to customers, wherein we explored in detail different types of formats like blogs, case studies, white papers, videos, podcasts, webinars, and many more to understand the different ways in which a brand can engage their customers, can connect with them, and deliver value to them repeatedly. These particular formats were discussed with the idea that these are essential elements of any content marketing campaign and any content marketing strategy, and only using these can a content marketer achieve the different goals which are established or which are set up in the marketing strategy development phase. Next, we discussed how to develop relevant content irrespective of format, whether you're designing text content or video content or audio content. What are the best practices? What are the standard procedures to be followed? What is the structure of good content? What is relevance? And how can you ensure that your content is of high quality, high relevance for your customer? Key takeaways from this particular chapter were in terms of understanding what makes sense, what is of interest to your customer, and how to produce it, what is the best way to go about it. Then we went on to discuss, after having created a good website, after having created relevant content in different formats for the company, how do you go about promoting this content? So we discussed various channels, social media, search, email, influencers, how with their help you can promote your content and drive your customer traffic, your site traffic, improve your engagement, improve the performance of your content, and overall have promising output from your content marketing strategy. And lastly, we talked about measuring the performance of content marketing strategy and campaigns using various KPIs and metrics, which are designed to either actually measure the quality of content or measure the symptom, the after effects, the output which good quality content can achieve from your campaign, especially in terms of ROI, leads, conversion, and traffic, of course. So in a nutshell, the course was designed keeping in mind that many of you are coming from non-marketing or non-management background and could still be considering this as a professional career fit. So the examples discussed, the strategy discussed, the process discussed is from the point of view of anyone who is just starting out on this path and is learning to be a content marketer. And I hope that that was the key learning for you, and you were able to assimilate as much information as you can, and you are ready to jump into this career as soon as you want to. So that's the end of content marketing course. Happy learning, and thank you.